Let's move over to the curve enhancements. Let's place ourselves in the Curve Tools tab, and you'll notice a new icon. It'll run the multiple offset command. As its name states, it allows you to select multiple curves at once and offset them to a same distance. And then select the side for your offset. Now I'll undo it and let's run the command again. I'd like to run through some of the options in the command, in particular, the corner options. Just as for the offset command, you can also set sharp corners to some other options. Let's try round. Validate, and again, click on the outside. You'll see that Rhino has replaced sharp corners with a true arc. Make sure to always explore the options within commands. Some of these can be truly useful. Let's move on to the next option. In this case, I will run the traditional offset command located over here. At this point, I'll just select my input curve and click on the outer side. I will run the command again, selecting my mirrored curve and activating the loose option. Again, clicking on the outer side. Let's compare. My original curve is within file tolerance at the exact distance that we set it to. Whereas with the loose option, I can see that areas where there's tight curvature, the distance varies. However, when I compare both curves, you'll notice that the traditional offset has a very dense control point structure, whereas the loose option has inherited the control point structure of the original curve. This is very useful if you will make geometry downstream using these curves, as a loose option will make simplified objects that will avoid problems downstream. Let's look at a similar option for the project command. Let's go over to the top viewport. I'll select my geometry, pressing Alt and dragging with the gumball to make a copy. Small trick. Now let's run the project command. I'll select my curves, press Enter, and select the case as the object to project onto. I'll do this again with my copy, this time making sure to choose the loose option. Now I'll select all curves and activate control points. Let's compare. In the original project option, you'll notice that the control point structure of the curves is also very dense, especially with curved objects, but also in the more linear segments. Whereas in the loose option, although the projected curves might not be within tolerance onto the surface, we have simplified versions of the curves, which again can be very useful downstream if you're building geometry off of these. The next example concerns an analysis tool new to V6. Let's go over to the New in V6 tab and run the Show Ends command. Show Ends allows you to select curves, press Enter, and it will open a box that will quickly allow you to analyze whether you have only closed curves, only open curves, and most importantly, where the curve seams are located. V6 also has new curve creation tools. Let's take a look at those. Over in the New in V6 tab, you'll see both icons sitting one next to each other. Let's start with the catenary curve. A catenary curve is a curve that simulates a hanging cable under its own weight. So, I get to pick a starting point, an endpoint, a curve direction, and a hanging height. I'll change the color for this. Let's take a look at our second command, parabola 3 points. Now, you could already create parabolas in Rhino 5, but this command allows you to set the points in order, picking the starting point, the midpoint, and the endpoint, and then, of course, giving it a direction. The curves might be similar in shape, but there are distinct differences, such as the parabola is a real conic. It's a degree 2 curve with a very simplified control point structure. The catenary curve, on the other hand, has an increasing control point distribution that allows simulating that hanging effect. The last feature we will show for this section concerns the blend curve command, and is probably the most important addition to V6 for curves. Let's take a look. Let's go over to the curve tools. And before running the command, make sure history is enabled up in the modeling aids bar. Click on the blend curve icon. Blend curve allows us to select two input curves and create a third one that we can interactively modify by pulling on the handles and changing the shape or changing the continuity condition. So far, everything is the same as in V5. The cool feature in V6 is the ability to rerun the command and enter edit mode. Edit mode allows us to select one of the blends in our file and go back into interactive mode, as if you had never quit the command. You can change any of the parameters in the dialog box, as well as changing the shape. This allows us to edit the blend curves at any point during the modeling process without having to delete them and recreate the shape. Also, combined with other history-enabled commands, it can be a very powerful modeling tool. For instance, if I go over to the solid tools and run the pipe command on my blend, and then enter edit mode again for the blend curve, I can change the shape as well as the continuity, and the pipe will readapt. These were some of the main features related to curves in Rhino 6 for Mac. Keep tuned for our next video, where we will be showing refinements and other new commands.